video. Okay, my previous lesson I have taught hybridization, isn't it? If you're new to this video, please watch that video. Okay, if you know the hybridization, we can predict the geometry, shape, structure, bond angle of given molecule. If these questions are very common in examination, okay, I will start with the example. You can understand and remember this topic. Okay, first I start with the carbon dioxide. CO2. Here, carbon is the central atom. Carbon is the central atom. Carbon comes under fourth group. So, if we know the group, we can tell the valency. So, valency of carbon is 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Here, neighboring atom is oxygen. Oxygen contribute with the two bonds, double bond, that makes double bond. Okay, so this is the pattern. So I explained in my previous video, please watch that video. So here we know the hybridization formula. Hybridization is equal to total number of bond pair or sigma bonds plus total number of lone pair. Okay, here total number of bond pair or sigma bonds. Here this is sigma bond, this is pi bond, this is sigma bond, this is pi bond. How many sigma bonds? Two sigma bonds. Is there any lone pairs? There is no lone pair, so zero. H is equal to 2. 2 means S plus P. S and P combined to give SP hybridization. Hybridization. Okay, so I give this linear structure here. So here A is carbon, X is oxygen. Okay, so here oxygen double bond, see double bond. So these three atoms lie on the same plane. If I put like this, the three atoms are on the same plane. So these are important concept here. So what is the bond angle? So bond angle of this molecule is 180 degree. 180 degree. So you can write like this. What is the structure? The structure is linear. What is the shape? The shape also same, linear. Shape only change when the lone pair electrons comes into the calculation. Okay, just remember that. Next, for sp2 I use bf3 example. Bf3, here boron is a central atom. Boron is a central atom. Boron comes in the third group. What is the valency of boron? 3. 1, 2, 3. Okay, so fluorine 1, 2, 3. So hybridization, H is equal to total number of bond pair electrons or sigma bond, 1, 2, 3. 3. Is there any lone pair? No, 0. So 3, 3 means S plus 2P. SP2 hybridization. So SP2 hybridization, here I give the structure like this. Okay, A, X, X, X. Instead of A, I put B, boron and fluorine. Here, fluorine. Okay, so this is a mistake. So these are in the same plane. Same plane. So all four atoms are in the same plane. Okay, so the structure or geometry is trigonal planar. Trigonal planar. Plane, the molecules are in plane, so we call it as a planar. Trigonal. So 1, 2, 3. So if the bond angle of this molecule is FBF, bond angle is 120 degree. 120 degree. Okay. So what is the shape? Shape also trigonal planar, because there is no lone pairs in this calculation. Okay, if any lone pair comes, the shape is varying. So for that I am going to use another example, SO2. Here sulfur is the central atom, the comes under the sixth group, so valency of the sulfur 6, 1 2 3 4 5 6. Oxygen coordinate with the 2, these two remaining lone pairs. Okay, what is the formula? H is equal to total number of sigma bonds, is a pi bond, total number of sigma bond 2, lone pair 1, so 3, same sp3. So sp3 means right, like the same like structure. Okay, xx, one lone pair, so put this lone pair here instead of this. Sulfur, oxygen, one oxygen, lone pair here. So oxygen is double bond, so put double bond. Okay, here geometry, trigonal planar is a geometry, but shape is a different shape. Here angular or V shape or bent, you must remember these three. Anyone may ask in your exam. So angular, V shape or bent. What is the bond angle? So up to this, so this bond angle is exact 120 degree, so this bond angle will reduce because this lone pair electrons, this lone pair electron ripple, this is a bond pair electron, so this bond angle reduce. Okay, so that up to 105 degree, that comes in the 105 degree. Okay, so like that you can remember. Okay, you can check with the next example. For sp3 example, ch4 carbon is the central atom, valency 4, 1 2 3 4. So hydrogen 1 1 1 1. What is the formula for the hybridization? H is equal to total number of bond pair electrons, total number of bond pair electrons here 1 2 3 4, 4 plus lone pair electron 0, so 4 means sp3 sp, so here sorry here sp2, so I made a mistake, sp2, this sp3. Okay, write the structure like this, x, this means this comes in the above the plane, this comes in the below the plane. Okay, if you place these molecules in the plane, these three atoms in the plane, this x comes above the plane, this comes in the below the plane. So only we use this representation, this is the stereochemical representation, three dimensional representation. Okay, so I put here carbon like this, one carbon below the plane, or another one hydrogen below the plane, one another hydrogen is above the plane. Okay, so above the plane, consider this hand is a plane, this pen means above the plane, this means below the plane. Okay, below the plane. So what is the bond angle? Bond angle is 109.5 degree. Okay, so what is the geometry? Geometry is tetrahedral, shape tetrahedral, both geometry and shapes are same because this have no lone pair electrons. Okay, so if within no one lone pair electrons, if one lone pair comes, what happens to the structure? We will take us the one example, ammonia NH3. Okay, NH3, for that example nitrogen is the central atom, Valency of nitrogen is 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Hydrogen 1, 2, 3. Remaining electrons, lone pair electrons. Hybridization H is equal to 3 plus 1. 4, 4 means, 4, 4 means sp3. So sp3 means, so same type structure, we draw x, above the plane or below the plane, you put one lone pair, okay, like this, one lone pair. So like this, ammonia, hydrogen below the plane, it's a lone pair, okay. So what is the structure or what is the geometry? Tetrahedral. What is the shape? So here one lone pair electrons comes, so shape is varying. Here shape is a pyramidal, so shape is pyramidal because one lone pair is come in the calculation, okay. If two lone pair comes in the calculation, what happens? For that I use H2O. Here central atom is oxygen, oxygen valence is 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So hydrogen 1, 2, remaining lone pair electrons. So hybridization H is equal to 2 plus 2 is equal to 4, 4 means sp3. So instead of this one X, I replace one lone pair electrons. So two lone pair electrons are replaced here. Okay, one is above the plane, another one is there below the plane. Okay, if you place a plane, one lone pair comes above the plane, another one comes in the below the plane. Okay, structure for the oxygen, water molecule O, H, one comes above the plane, one comes below the plane, okay. So here what about the bond angle of ammonia? NHH 107.8 degree. Here 104.48 degree. So what is the geometry? Tetrahedral is the geometry. So what is the shape? Shape is V shape or bent. So here so like the same angular V shape or bent. Angular so these are shape because two lone pair electrons comes here, okay. So another example, so for sp3d hybridization, for sp3d hybridization I am using pcl5. P phosphorus comes in the central atom, so 5 coordination number, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 5 chlorine, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, so here H is equal to 5 plus 0, 5, 5 means sp3d, so the structure of phosphorus pentachloride, phosphorus is central atom, so chlorine, well, write like this chlorine, okay. So I like to use another paper, you can easily see PCl. These three comes in the same plane, okay. Another two chlorine comes in the below the plane and one comes in the above the plane, another comes in the below the plane. Okay, so we call this as a axial, this equatorial. Okay, so this concept I will explain in the Jaunteller effects, Jaunteller distortion. There we need this representation. Okay, here the axial bond length, axial to axial, that means chlorine, phosphorus, chlorine, this length, this angle is 180 degree. Okay, so axial equatorial means this chlorine, phosphorus, this chlorine, angle is 120 degree. Equatorial axial, this equatorial axial phosphorus, chlorine, phosphorus, chlorine, this angle is 90 degree. Okay, because this is the perpendicular to the plane, so perpendicular to the plane, so that is 90 degree. Okay, then example for SF4. So the structure comes, so here calculation, H is equal, S is the central atom, 6 valency, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, fluorine, 1, 2, 3, 4, the remaining is H is, hybridization is equal to 4 plus 1, 5, so sp3d hybridization, so sp3d hybridization, replace one lone pair electrons from this place, okay, and substitute others. So sulfur, fluorine, above the plane on fluorine, below the plane on fluorine, so lone pair comes in the equatorial position, lone pair comes in the equatorial position. Okay, so these are in the same plane, this lone pair and fluorines are in the equatorial position. These are in the equatorial position. This is axial position, this is equatorial position. Very, very important. Okay, most of the students did mistake in here. Okay, so what is the geometry? Geometry is the trigonal by pyramidal. So here geometry is trigonal by pyramidal. Okay, shape also same, but here shape is not same because one lone pair is there, so shape is differ, shape is seesaw, shape is seesaw or distorted tetrahedral. Okay, next example. So here you can see sp3, so bond pair, so example cl4, so clf3, chlorine is the central atom, and the valency of chlorine is 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, so fluorine 1, 2, 3, so remaining lone pairs. Okay, so based on this calculation, bond pair 2 lone pair 3 so structure is ax3. So here the lone pairs comes in the equatorial position, these are the axial position, these two are axial position, these are in the equatorial position. So the geometry is trigonal bipyramidal, the shape is T, the structure like T shape. So here the bond angle, axial bond angle xax, the bond angle is 175, so nearly 180 degree. So axial equatorial 87.5 degree, so nearly 90 degree. Okay, so this is the example for this. If comes in the two lone pair, if the electron is reduced, so lone pair is 2 plus 3, so example is xcf2 is the example for this. So xenon comes in the 8th group, so 8 valency, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 2 fluorine occupy here, 2 lone pair, lone pair. So here 2 bond pairs, 2 bond pairs, 3 lone pairs. What is the hybridization formula? H is equal to 2 plus 3. 3 means 2 plus 3, 5. 5 means sp3d, sp3d hybridization, sp3d hybridization. Okay, so the type of molecule is ax2. Here you can see the 3 lone pairs are occupied in the equatorial position. These are the equatorial position. So the neighboring groups are participated in the axial position. Okay, so what is the geometry? Geometry is trigonal bipyramidal. So geometries are same, trigonal bipyramidal, but here the molecules looks in the linear shape. 1 x a x linear, so linear, this is linear, so x a x, so linear. So the a axial axial bond length, a x bond angle is 180 degree. So example is xenon fluoride. Okay, so next, for example for sp3d2. So here the same, whatever we did previously, the same, like we just copy the structure. You just see the here where we replace the lone pair electrons, that is very important. So here you can see we replace the lone pair in axial position. This is axial, this is axial. Okay, these are in the equatorial position. So these are in the same plane, x a x a x, these are in the same plane. One is above the plane, another is below the plane. This geometry we call octahedral, shape is octahedral. Okay, so axial, axial, so x a x bond angle is 180 degree. A x bond angle, axial equatorial bond angle, axial equatorial perpendicular, so 90 degree. Equatorial equatorial also 90 degree. This 90 degree, this x equatorial a x e, so also 90 degree. Okay, so here we replace the lone pair. If bond pair is 5, lone pair is 1, so type of molecule is ax5. Here we replace lone pair in axial position. So what is the geometry? Geometry is octahedral, shape is square pyramidal, square pyramidal. So this is like square shape and comes in the pyramid like structure, pyramid like structure. So we call that as a square pyramidal, square pyramidal. So here also the bond angles are same, nearly 90 degree, and axial equatorial 84.8 degree. So example, bromine pentafluoride. So you work out this. Okay, check whether the structure is same or not. So if the bond pair is 4, the lone pair is 2, so type of molecule is ax4. Here you can check the both lone pairs are occupied in the axial position. So what is the difference between octahedral geometry and the trigonal bipyramidal geometry? In trigonal bipyramidal geometry, you can see, so the lone pairs are occupied in the equatorial position, but in octahedral geometry, the lone pairs are occupying the axial position. This is very, very important. Okay, so these two lone pairs are occupying the equatorial position. So the geometry is octahedral, shape is square planar. So square planar bond angle is, this bond angle is 90 degree. Okay, so example is xenon tetrafluoride, xenon tetrafluoride. Okay, so like this you can copy this. So sp3d3 also like this. Here also comes, this is for bond pair is 7, lone pair is 0, ax7. The molecular structure is like this, pentagonal bipyramidal. Pentagonal means 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, this pentagonal, 5, pentagonal. So these are in the same plane. Okay, so these are axial bonds, these are axial, 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 so sorry, equatorial, equatorial. These 5 are in equatorial. One neighboring atom comes above the plane, another atom comes in the below the plane. This axial, this comes in the axial. Okay, so the geometry is pentagonal bipyramidal, shape is pentagonal bipyramidal. So axial, axial, XAX. Bond angle is this, above the plane and below the plane. Bond angle is 180 degree. So equatorial, this XAX bond angle is 72 degree. Okay. So axial equatorial, XAX, this axial X and equatorial X. AXAX bond angle is 90 degree. This bond angle is 90 degree. Okay. Because that is perpendicular. So perpendicular is this, one is below the plane, another one is above the plane. If the bond pair is 6, lone pair is 1, the structure is like this. So here this 5 atoms are in the plane, same plane. So one atom below the plane replace one lone pair electrons. One lone pair electrons is replaced in the below the plane. Okay. So what is the geometry? Geometry is a pentagonal bipyramidal. Shape is pentagonal pyramidal. Here bipyramidal, here pyramidal, because we replaced one atom with one lone pair electrons. So here the example is XeOF5-. Okay. That is the example. You just check it. So if bond pair is 2, 5, lone pair is 2, so the type of molecule is AX5. AX5 means you replace two axial bond with two lone pairs. So these fives are in the pentagonal. So replace this lone pairs. So replace this lone pair. So the geometry is pentagonal bipyramidal. Shape is pentagonal planar. Pentagonal planar. So two axial positions are occupied with the lone pairs. Okay. So just remember this, octahedral and pentagonal bipyramidal, we replace the axial position for lone pair electrons. Lone pair electrons are occupied in the axial position, and trigonal bipyramidal equatorial position. Okay, just remember this. Okay. So I just revise. If you know the coordination number or geometry or the number of hybridization, okay, so if you know the hybridization, we can assign the geometry. So for 2 linear, 3 trigonal planar, 4 tetrahedral, 5 trigonal bipyramidal, 6 octahedral, 7 pentagonal bipyramidal, 8 dodecahedron, 9 tricapped trigonal prismatic, 10 bicapped square antiprism, 11 octadodecahedron, 12 icosahedron. Okay, so you can use this technique and you can identify the hybridization number and you can apply here. Okay, if any lone pair comes, only the shape will vary. Shape is varying with the lone pair electrons. Okay, if there is no lone pair electrons, you can just use this geometry. Okay, I hope you like this video. If you like this video, please share with your friends. If you didn't subscribe, please subscribe my channel.